Hi, here's Kathaayaana wishing everyone a very happy Children's Day. We celebrate Children's Day today because it is our country's first Prime Minister, Shri Pandit Jawaharlal Nehru Ji's birthday. Nehru Ji used to love children a lot, and children used to love Nehru Ji as well, and lovingly they used to call him Chacha Nehru. And Nehru Ji also used to say, used to believe that our children of today are our country's future. All these things we know, generally we all know this. However, there is one thing which quite a few people might know, and it is this, that Nehru Ji's daughter, Indira Gandhi Ji, as we all know, when she was a child, her name was only Indira. When Indira Ji was a child, she used to ask a lot of questions to Nehru Ji, which left him most of the times perplexed, and he did not know how to express the answers efficiently. And it so happened once that when Indira Ji was 10 years old, she had gone to Mussoorie to spend her summer vacations. And Nehru Ji had stayed back in their hometown at Allahabad. And then Nehru Ji took that chance to answer all of Indira Ji's questions in the form of writing letters to her. Yes, and the subjects that were covered in these letters were regarding ancient natural history and human civilizations, like how was Earth formed, which was the first living being that came into existence and how it looked like, how was a man born, how did he start speaking a language, how were different countries formed, how did the different religions and cultures grow, and many other topics were dealt in these letters, and a total of 30 letters were written to her. And eventually all these letters were collected and made into a book titled Letters from a Father to His Daughter. And now I'm going to read one letter from that book, and the title of that letter is The Relationships of Languages. Dear Indira, in the previous letter, we have seen how the Aryans spread out over many countries and carried their language, whatever it was, wherever they went. But different climates and different conditions produced many differences in various groups of the Aryans. Each group went on changing in its own way with new habits and customs. They could not meet the other groups in other countries, as it was exceedingly difficult to travel about in those days. Each group was cut off from the others. If the people of one country learned something new, they could not tell it to the people of another country. So changes came in, and after many generations, the one Aryan family became split up into many. Perhaps they even forgot that they all belonged to one large family. Their one language became many languages, which seemed to differ greatly from each other. But although they seemed so different, there were many common words and similarities. Even now, after thousands of years, we can find these common words in different languages and can tell that once upon a time, these languages must have been one. You know that there are many such common words in French and English. Let us examine two very homely and ordinary words like father and mother. In Hindi and Sanskrit, the words are, as you know, pita and mata. In Latin, they are pater and mater. In Greek, pateras and mitera. In German, vater and mutter. And in French, père and mère. And so on in many other languages. Do they not all seem to be very much alike? They have a resemblance of family, like cousins. Many words, of course, may be borrowed by one language from another. Hindi has borrowed many words from English, and in this way, and English has borrowed some words from Hindi. But father and mother could not have been borrowed. There cannot be new words. Right at the beginning, when people started talking to each other, there were, of course, fathers and mothers, and words must have been found for them. Therefore, we can say that these words are not borrowed. They must have come down from the same ancestor or the same family. And from this, we can find out that the people living far apart now in different countries are using different languages must have belonged once upon a time to the same big family. You will see how interesting the study of languages is and what a lot it teaches us. If we know three or four languages, it is not very difficult to learn more languages. You will also see that most of us now living in different countries far from each other long ago were one people. We have changed greatly since then, and many of us have forgotten our old relationships. In every country, people imagine that they are the best and the cleverest, and the others are not as good as they are. The Englishman thinks that he and his country are the best. The Frenchman is very proud of France and everything French. The Germans and Italians think no end of their countries. And many Indians imagine that India is in many ways the greatest country in the world. This is all conceit. Everybody wants to think well of himself and his country. But really, there is no person who has not got some good in him and some bad. And in the same way, there is no country which is not partly good and partly bad. We must take the good wherever we find it and try to remove the bad wherever it may be. We are, of course, most concerned with our own country, India. Unhappily, it is in a bad way today, and most of our people are very poor and miserable. They have no pleasure in their lives. We have to find out how we can make them happier. We have to see what is good in our ways and customs and try to keep it, and whatever is bad, we have to throw away. If we find anything good in other countries, we should certainly take it. As Indians, we have to live in India and work for India. But we must not forget that we belong to the larger family of the world, and the people living in other countries are, after all, our cousins. It would be such an excellent thing if all the people in the world were happy and contented. We have, therefore, to try to make the world a happier place to live in. Yours lovingly, Jawaharlal. When you were a child, or if you are a child, have you ever received such a kind of a letter from an elder person? Or if you are an elder person, have you ever written such a kind of a letter to a child? If yes, and if you are interested to talk about it, Kathaayaana would be very glad to receive stories about those letters in the form of letters written to kathaayaana@gmail.com. The address is given in the description box. This is Lakshmi taking your leave. See you all soon. Bye.